Welcome, tankers and postscriptum gamers, to episode 0 of our Armor Brief series. I'm Wet Squad member Kaz, and today I'll be doing an overview of tank ammunition types. Keep in mind that we have not been able to access a test server yet, but we are working on getting that for the following episodes. Lastly, before getting started, the armored update for postscriptum is somewhat of a work in progress, meaning that shell ballistics and post-penetration effects are subject to change. Therefore, I'll be giving you suggestions about which ammunition types to use in different situations based on the experience of myself and crew and the information available online about their real-life counterparts. I think starting with the Allies will be most useful because their ammunition is less straightforward than the Axis. Firstly, for the American faction, as of December 2nd, 2021, there are effectively three tanks to choose from: the M4A3 Sherman and its Utah Beach snorkel variant, the M5 Stuart Light Tank, and the M4A3E8 Sherman, also known as the EZ8. Before the armored update, there was also the M10 Wolverine and the M18 Hellcat. However, these tank destroyers are not yet ready for the new update. And according to information I got from the Postscriptum official Discord, they and the Panzer 470 will be released in the future when they are ready. I have digressed, but back to the topic of ammunition. For the 75mm gun on the M4A3, there are two types of ammunition available: APT and APCBCHET. These are armor-piercing tracer and armor-piercing capped ballistic cap high explosive tracer. Comparing them will help make sense as to when to use them. APT ammunition does not have a steel cap, ballistic cap, nor a high explosive filler. The steel cap is exactly what it sounds like, a steel cap that helps the round penetrate sloped surfaces better. The ballistic cap is a cap that covers both the shell and the steel cap, and its purpose is to help make the round cut through the air and reduce its air drag. This is beneficial because the round will impact the target with more speed and thus transfer more kinetic energy to the target. It also helps with trajectory. The high explosive part is a small charge of high explosive filler that will detonate when the round begins to penetrate the armor. And this will help not penetration, but the post-penetration effects of the shell, making it more deadly when it penetrates. Therefore, in both of the M4A3 Shermans, the APC-BCHET round is the most effective to use against tanks. However, against light German armor and flat surfaces, the APT still serves a purpose. Yet I think having the APC-BCHET loaded first is always the way to go. In the M5 light tank, there are similar options: APT and APC. No ballistic caps here, but the APC will give you better effects against sloped armor, and as it will be with all the ammunition throughout this episode. Having a cap of some kind is always better than straight AP. Lastly, for the American faction, the M4A3E8, there is APT, APCBCHET, and HVAP or HVAP. The two former ammunition types behave the same way as I've already described, but the HVAP round is high-velocity armor-piercing. This round was designed with ballistics in mind. It is more aerodynamically efficient than the other two ammo types, and it boasts a higher penetration value in-game. However, it lacks the mass and high-explosive filler that the APCBCHET round has, and because of this, it lacks some post-penetration effects. With that being said, I think that tankers in the EZ8 should use their APCBCHE most of the time, but swap to HVAP when you need to make sure you penetrate at all costs, like when you're trying to kill an enemy gunner through his turret. I have read that this round behaved in real life somewhat poorly against sloped surfaces, but I cannot confirm or deny this is expressed in game. Now to move on to the British tanks. There are the Daimler and Staghound light tanks, Matilda and Churchill heavy tanks, and the Firefly and Cromwell medium tanks. To start with the heavy tanks, the Matilda only gets AP, so you get no choice. But the Churchill has APC, APBC, and APDS. Armor-piercing capped will provide better penetration effects versus angled and sloped armor than the armor-piercing ballistic capped. However, the APBC boasts better penetration numbers at all distances thanks to its superior ballistics. Therefore, I suggest using APC at closer ranges, against sloped armor. But when you have a flatter surface to fire at, even at long range, the APBC will perform better than the former. Lastly, there is APDS, Armor Piercing Discarding Sabo. And this is the best round available in the Churchill. It boasts one of the highest penetration values of any tank in game, and from my experience in game, it cuts through armor with ease, and it can detonate ammo racks instantly if you score a direct hit. With that being said, you only get 10 rounds of APDS, so maybe save them for when you absolutely need them. Now, on to the light tanks. The Daimler has AP and APHV, or Armor Piercing High Velocity. It also gets APHE. These rounds have similar penetration overall, but the APHV boasts the highest penetration values, and the APHE will provide the best post-penetration effects, yet it has the lowest of the three, penetration-wise. In this tank, I suggest using the AP and swapping to the APHV when you need a little something extra. The Staghound is very basic and offers APT and APC. And as I said earlier, cap is always better than no cap, so use the APC in the Staghound. Now, onto the medium tanks. The Cromwell has the same ammo types as the Churchill, except that the Cromwell shells are tracer. Therefore, the same conclusion as the Churchill applies here. The Firefly has APT, APCT, and APCBCT. Therefore, the more caps, the better. APCBC is your best round in the Firefly, and I can say from experience that it is devastating to German ammo racks and components. Last up for the Allies are the French tanks, which there are three to choose from. The Panhard Scout Tank, the R35, and the S35. Both the Panhard and the S35 only get one option, so you get no choice. But the R35 gets two, APCR and APHE. The Armor Piercing Composite Rigid is similar to the American HVAP round in that it is designed for maximum ballistic efficiency, and it boasts a higher penetration value than the APHE, which has more post-penetration effects. For the R35, I suggest using the APCR, simply because the APHE has abysmal penetration values. Do not try to shoot a tank with APHE, because at least according to the armor viewer in the hangar, it cannot even reliably penetrate the rear of light German armor like the Panzer II and 38T. Now finally, I've come to the Axis tanks. For the early war tanks, there are the Panzer 38T, the Panzer II, the Panzer IIIF, Panzer IVD, and the Stug 3A. These tanks have very simple loadouts, as the 38T, Panzer II, and Panzer IIIF get APCR for when you need to punch through thick armor, and a standard AP shell. Against tanks, I suggest using the APCR in the P2. And for the other two, I suggest using the AP round but swapping to the APCR when you need more penetration. For the late war tanks, there is the Panzer IV H, the Panzer IV H with side skirts, the Panther, Tiger, King Tiger, Puma, and the Stug 3G. When operating all of these vehicles, your best choice is the APC-BC-HET, except when you're in the Puma, because it gets APC-HET, so it doesn't get a ballistic cap. This round provides great penetration, ballistic and post-penetration effects, but when you need it, they all come with APCR for those crucial must-penetrate shots. However, I do suggest always loading the APC-BC first. There is one last ammo type that the Axis has available, which is heat. This round does not penetrate armor based on kinetic energy, and instead it has a shaped charge warhead that detonates on impact, causing a chemical reaction that focuses a lot of energy on one small point. However, according to Snazzy Duckling in the Postscriptum official Discord, all heat rounds, this includes Panzerfaust, Bazooka, Piat, and the Raketenpanzerbukes of 54, and heat shells from tanks, will all bounce if there is more than a 30 degree angle of impact on surfaces at least 30 millimeters in thickness. Therefore, I do not think this round is very effective as a choice for killing tanks, but I do not have any in-game experience with it yet, which hopefully, when we go tank by tank in this series, I will be able to speak more to. That's all for episode 0 of our Postscriptum Armor Brief series. And if you enjoyed or learned something from this video, please consider subscribing to or sharing our channel. We love Postscriptum and hope that we can help the game grow by making it more available in media and by making it more approachable for new players. So let us know in the comments, which tank do you want to see in our first episode of Armor Briefs? See you out there, tankers. This is Kaz, signing off.